Hello my dear students, in this topic we are going to see two theory questions on gear. The first question was asked in 2014, that is GATE 2014 for 1 mark. Actually this is a question from theory of machine subject, that is in theory of machine. In first topic you will learn this concept, right? But here we are covering because it is based on the gear. The question is, for a given statement, first, matings per gear teeth is an example of higher pair. Second, a revolute joint is an example of lower pair. Indicate the correct answer. Means which statement is correct or which statement is wrong. About this, this is a question. Now, before this, let us understand lower pair and higher pair. Right. Higher pair means in mating surfaces or in mating components. Mating means there is a contact between two components. There is either point contact or there is a line contact. Right. For example, gears. In case of gears, there is a line contact. Let us say this is a gear. This is a pinion and this is a gear. Right. Between this pinion and gear, you can see here, smaller one is called pinion, a larger one is called gear, right? You can see here, let us say point P. If I consider this point P, at this point P, there is a contact, but this is a line contact, my dear students, because they will be having some thickness. If I see another view will look like this, right? Means at this location there is a line contact, right? Therefore, as there is a line contact, it is an example of higher pair. Therefore, the first statement, which is mating spur gear teeth, is an example of higher pair. Yes, 100% correct. This is a correct statement. Now go to the second statement. Second statement is a revolute joint is an example of lower pair. Now lower pair means there is a surface contact. The meaning of lower pair is surface contact. We can say surface or area contact. Area contact. Such as, let us say, one object. This object is kept on ground. Now, this object will be having some area. Right. There is an area contact or not. This lower area is in contact with ground. Right. Therefore, it is a... this pair is a lower pair. Now, revolute joint means there is a pin, right? Revolute joint is a pin joint, right? Therefore, pin joint is always surface contact. Therefore, it is a example of lower pair only. Therefore, second statement is also true. Therefore, both one and two are true. Therefore, option D is correct choice. Here, option D is correct choice. Right. This question is from theory of machine, but as they are asking for particularly spur gear, that's why I have covered here. Now let us go for next question. Now the second question, which was asked in same year, that is GATE 2014, but in another set. Previous one was asked in set 1, this was asked in set 4 for again 1 mark. Again, this is very simple question. Question is, which one of the following is used to convert a rotational motion into translation motion? Now we know that rack and pinion gear is used to convert linear motion into rotational motion or rotational motion into linear motion, right? Here, for option D is the correct choice, rack and pinion. Here, pinion is smaller one which rotates. Rack is of infinite radius. Rack is having radius is equal to infinite. That is, there will be a linear motion. Infinite radius motion means linear motion. Therefore, linear motion of rack is converted into rotational motion of pinion, or rotational motion of pinion is converted into linear motion of rack. Let us understand diagrammatically. Here, this is a rack, and here smaller one is a pinion. You can see this is a pinion. which is rotating. This pinion is rotating. And here it is a rack, and this rack will, while pinion is rotating, this rack will move linearly, right? For clockwise rotation of pinion, the rack will move towards left, and for anti-clockwise rotation of pinion, the rack will move towards right, right? And here it is a linear motion. For rack there will be a linear motion, for pinion there will be a rotational motion, and rack is having infinite radius, and pinion will be having some radius, right? Now therefore, rack and pinion assembly is used to convert linear motion into rotational motion or rotational motion into linear motion. And my dear students, if we talk about here bevel gear, in case of bevel gear power is transferred at 90 degree, but here also rotation and here also rotation, means rotational motion is converted into rotational motion only, right? In case of double helical gear, again there are two parallel shafts, between these two parallel shafts rotational motion is transferred into rotational motion only. And in case of worm gear, again there are two non-parallel, non-intersecting shafts, and rotational motion is transferred into rotational motion only. Thank you, dear students. In next lecture, we will start new topic.